forget what name they be. Purita's surname and day. Wish new partly Namastopium. Part of Persian's wish of me. Namaste everyone. My name is Namrishi. And I'm 6 years old. I'm literally much after Simon. I don't know what God to do, Simon. Was having the ocean, natural clouds, the mountains, desert chest. Who is the voice of the Lord Vishnu? Please forgive me for touching you with my foot.
Hey everyone, my name is Keisha and I'm 10 years old. Today I'm going to speak about Sanatan Dharma. From all the religions of the world, Hinduism is the oldest. No date can be fixed for Hinduism. It's not founded by any prophet. It's not based on a set of dogmas preached by a particular set of teachers. It's free from religious fanaticism. The actual name for Hinduism is Sanatan Dharma. It is also known as Vaidic Dharma. Dharma is derived from the Sanskrit root verb tri, which means to hold together. It has a wider meaning than the word religion. Religion literally means that which leads one to God. There is no equivalent word for them either in English or in any other language. In this sense, Hinduism is not a religion. It's a dharma. Sanatan means eternal, and in simple terms, dharma means code of good conduct. For example, by doing the right thing in thought, word, and deed. So Sanatan dharma is a way of life. Sanatan dharma is not a belief. It is something you can know by analysis and experiment. It is open for everyone regardless of any caste, creed, color, gender, or religion one belongs to. Sanatan Dharma allows absolute freedom to the rational mind of man. There is no restriction upon the freedom of human reason, the freedom of thought, feeling, and will of man. It allows absolute freedom to the human reason and heart with regard to questions such as nature of God, soul, creation, form of worship, and the goal of life. It allows everybody to reflect, investigate, inquire, and think deeply. Hence, all sorts of religious faiths, spiritual practices, and diverse kinds of rituals and customs have found their honorable places side by side within Hinduism. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Sehan, I'm 10 years old, and this is my little sister.
She is the like smallest of our group.
Sanatan Dharma also pays respect to other religions. It says that people of all of the religions worship the same God, whether we know them by different names such as Allah, Jesus Christ, Supreme Being, Buddha, or many others. They all refer to the God that manifests in the universe and beyond and in nature. It is said in the Rig Veda that Ekam Sat Vipra Bahudha Vedanti. There is only but one truth, even though we know it by different names. Sanatan Dharma doesn't believe in conversion. It offers all different types of spiritual practices and ways to worship for different types of people to suit their interests, capacities, mental, intellectual, and physical levels. People of all of the religions are free to follow the practices within Sanatan Dharma with respect and conservation of their own religion. Sanatan Dharma has its fundament in science and logic. One logic reasoning is, there is no such time, there was no such time, and there will be no such time that the physical, mental, and intellectual capacities of each and every individual is, was, or will be the same. Hence, compelling everyone to practice the same and choose the same is equal to injustice. Hence, everyone has the right to make their own choices according to their abilities and capacities.
Yes.
Thank you.
Today I'm
going to
speak about
the three parts of Sanatan Dharma. Sanatan Dharma is the ethical and moral way of living for each and every human being. class of regardless of caste, creed, color, religion, and gender. It is established that Sanatan Dharma has three parts of mark: Gyan mark, path of knowledge; Bhakti mark, path of devotion; and Karma mark, path of actions. As human beings, we all have three main body parts: head, heart, and hands. Head is a place of knowledge, heart is a place of love and emotion, and hands are to perform actions. So we all use these three aspects simultaneously to perform our personal, social, and ritual duties. Likewise, all these three aspects are equally important to achieve salvation, the ultimate goal of human life. Sanatan Dharma incorporates all these three parts as a complete way of life. So we need to adopt all these three parts to have good conduct in action, speech, and mind, and to have good self-realization and salvation. Thank you.
Ji, namaste everyone. My name is Gautam, I'm 10 years old. Although we have to follow the three paths side by side, one of the three becomes dominant in us. The path which prevails in us is determined by our personality, ability, and liking. Among all human beings, you will find three main types of people. The first are the intellectual types. In them, Gyan mind is dominant. The second are the emotional ones. In them, Bhakti mind is dominant. The third are the energetic ones. In them, Karma mind is dominant. In the Bhagavad Gita, these are called Yoga. Bhagavan Sri Krishna describes Gyan Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, and Karma Yoga. He describes how one can achieve self-realization and salvation through these yoga. Thank you.
9 years old. I will be telling you about the three paths. The first path is Gyan Mai, which is the path of knowledge. Try to gain knowledge through the scriptures and from a guru. In the light of your wisdom, try to discriminate good from bad. Knowledge purifies your inner self and helps you to know about God. The next mark is Bhakti mark, which is the path of devotion. Try to surrender yourself to the lotus feet of Bhagavanji. Accept this whole creation as a form of Bhagavanji and serve it as you would serve him. This is true devotion. The final mark is Karma mark, which is the path of action. Perform your duties, whether personal or social, with all your capacity and ability without expecting any reward. Surrender each action to Bhagavan. We go to Sanma for sure. Thank you.
Yes, so I want to say the mantras my ancestors were
saying. Yeah, come on.
Come on.
I said to Mama, say the way of Kamasama, don't take the way of Kamasama.
Very good. Thanks so much, Jyoti Rana.
Pranam?
Pranam, Didi Ji. Namaste, everyone. My name is Rishi. I'm 6.5 years old. I'm telling the meaning of Asatoma Sankamaya over Vaji. Please lead us from our group.
Okay, so
my name is Zubili and I am 7.5 years old and I will be talking about four forms of Sanatan Dharma. What is the true form of Dharma? Is there offering all kinds of rituals such as puja and havan, or is it maybe to believe in God or maybe worship the mountain? None of these forms are forms of Dharma. As mentioned before, Dharma is code of good conduct, which means doing the right thing in word, thought, and deed. When we perform rituals out of love and gratitude to Bhagavanji, it purifies our mind and makes us more focused. It helps us to live a moral life. But when we perform rituals to fulfill some selfish desire, it doesn't purify us, neither makes us a good person. Somebody who believes in God and goes to Mandir and performs all kinds of rituals and also perform bad actions, have evil thoughts, and speak evil. Such as a person is not a follower of him. Like these things around my head, Ravan believes in God and worships Lord Shiva. His actions and thoughts are evil. That's why, although being a Brahmin, you call Ravan a Rakshas, demon slash evil-minded person. Ravan is not a follower of Dharma, but he is a follower of Adharma.
Today we talk about Ahimsa. Pram, Dharam, Shruti, Vidita, Ahimsa. According to scripture, Ahimsa is the first form of Dharma, non-violence. Ahimsa also means not to cause any pain or suffering to anyone by actions, thoughts, or speech. Ahimsa by personal gains. Ahimsa also means not to tolerate any injustice. Thank you.
Pranam BBG, Namaste everyone. My name is JT and I am 10 years old. Today I'm going to be talking about four forms of Sanatan Dharma. Dharma nadu sarasatya samana, meaning there is no other dharma than truth. The second form of dharma is satya, meaning truth. We should always follow the path of truth and remove any deceit, fraud, lies, and injustice. We should always try to speak the truth without any fears. Meaning, oh brother, there is no other dharma like benefiting others. The third form of dharma is badahit, meaning welfare of others. We should not be selfish and only think about ourselves. We should always think about welfare of others and perform such kinds of actions which are beneficial for all. Dharma ki daya sarasahari jana, meaning, O Garuda, there is no other dharma like mercy. The fourth form of dharma is daya, meaning mercy. We should feel mercy for someone in pain and suffering. We should try to help remove their pain and suffering, and also try to help remove. We should always try to help the needy ones. Thank you.
Thank you, Brooke, and I am 8 years old. Pranam, DDG. Namaste, everyone. My name is Vanju Sada, and I am 9 years old. Today, we are going to be talking about 10 principles of Dharma. In one of our scriptures, the manuscript, there are 10 principles of Dharma mentioned, which indicates the Dharma. When we follow all these 10 principles, it keeps the Dharma in harmony. The person with all these symptoms is an ideal human being prepared completely for his journey to self-realization and salvation. Number one, dhriti, having patience even in difficult times of life, which results from inner strength and courage. Number two, shama, the ability to forgive and forget. We can only forgive when we are a spiritually strong and broad-minded person. We should be able to forgive even our enemies, like Lord Rama has taught. Number three, Dhamma, control over mind and desire. We should not be led by our uncontrolled desires to make decisions in life, but decisions should be taken by a stable mind free from worldly attachment and fear. Number four, Asteya, practice non-stealing through honesty and goodness. We should have ownership only of those things which are earned by hard work and labor.
Number five, Shauch, have internal and external purity. We should not only clean our body and surroundings, but we should also purify the mind by removing negative emotions, desires, and attachments. Number six, Indriya Nigraha, controlling the senses. We have five senses through which we perceive the world. Ears for sound, eyes for form, tongue for taste, nose for smell, and skin for touch. Through these senses, we should try to perceive only the good and positive things through control of senses. Number seven, Dhi, wisdom, indicates the power to discriminate between right and wrong. Always choose right paths and proceed, even when difficulties are on your way. Number 8, Vidya, knowledge, refers to the education as well as the practical knowledge about life. True knowledge makes you humble. Number 9, Satya, always follow the path of truth, even in difficult situations. Number 10, Akrodha, absence of anger. Try to remain calm in all circumstances. Be patient and strong to gain victory by our willpower over our emotions. Thank you.
What is he saying?
Devi Shamadamodayam Shoshan Indriya Nikala Duvida Satya Kodo Dashatam Dramvalashanam.
Silence, please. Quiet, everyone.
Yes.
Pranam, Didi, Namaste, everyone. My name is Bhumika Sherman. I'm 9 years old. And today I'll be telling you about Panchadeva Upasana. Panch means five, Dev means deity, and Upasana means to worship. According to Sanatan Dharma, there's only one God. He is the supreme, all-powerful, one residing everywhere and in everyone. He is the one without any forms or colors. Yet, on the other hand, he is the one with countless forms. This whole creation was the projection of Bhagwanji. So each form in this creation is Bhagwanji. This creation is also infinite, so there are also infinite forms of Bhagwanji. So how do you know which form to worship? Well, Sanatan Dharma provides a wonderful arrangement of which Bhagwanji worship, which is called the Panchadeva Upasana. As I told you before, Panch means five, Dev means deity, and Upasana means to worship. The way we should worship Bhagwan is the five forms. We should worship Bhagwan is in the five effects which we also have. We all have a name, form, power, love, and knowledge. Now I will tell you the five manifestations or the five forms, the way we should worship Bhagwan. The name of God is Bhagwan, the nature. The love of God is Vishnu Bhagwan. The power of God is Maha Durga. The name of God is Bhagwan. The knowledge of God is Shiv Bhagwan. And the form of God is Surya Bhagwan, the God of Sun. Thank you.
Namaste, everyone. My name is Tanishka. I'm 8 years old. I'll tell you the name of God. The name of God. The name of God is personified in the Bhagwan Ganesha. The name is our first identification. That is why we worship the Bhagwan Ganesha. The Bhagwan in any puja. Bhagwan Ganesha is destroyer of all evil and obstacles and giver of success. Therefore, we always worship Bhagwan Ganesha for good. To
start any auspicious.
In any auspicious ceremonies or studying something new to achieve success. We also worship Ganesha Ji for good education, wisdom, and love.
Today I'll be talking about the form of God. The form of God is Surya, the sun. The sun is the source of our lives. We are all given life from the sun. Without the sun, no forms are possible on this earth. We can only see forms because of the light of the sun in our eyes. Light stands for wisdom, so we worship the sun with a godly mantra. And we also worship the sun for good wisdom in our eyes and for any skin disease. Thank you.
Very good.
Namaste everyone. My name is Yamini and I'm 7 years old. Today I'm going to be talking about the knowledge of God. The knowledge of God is Shivpukwa. Knowledge means to know, and we can only know something when the opposite of that exists. For example, we only know what light is because there is darkness. We only know what happiness is because there is sorrow. Shiva means auspicious. He is also called Shankar, which means he who grant auspiciousness to all. Shiva is the Lord of mercy and compassion. He protects devotees from evil forces such as lust, greed, and anger. He grants boons, bestows grace, and awakens wisdom in his devotees. Thank you.
Pranam Didiji, Namaste everyone. My name is Prem, I'm 9 years old. Today I'm going to talk about the power of God. The power of God is Madurga. Durga stands for the unified symbol of all divine forces, Shakti. So Madurga is also known as Shakti, power. Madurga rises
the blue bench, bench or screen, Madurga.
Madurga rises online and shows she has infinite power. Madurga is the destroyer of sin and the protector of morality. Madurga is the divine mother who protects people from evil forces such as selfishness, jealousy, hatred, anger, and ego. We worship Madurga to gain victory upon our evil thoughts and intentions and to overcome all bad obstacles in our life. Thank you.
Namaste everyone. My name is Isha and I'm 8 years old. I'm going to talk about the love of God. The love of Bhagavan Vishnu, Bhagavan Ram, and Bhagavan Krishna all represent the love of God. From all these forms, we learn about love and morality, how we can become ideal in all our relations, such as an ideal son or daughter, an ideal husband or wife, or an ideal friend. Thank you.
Okay, thank you all. So you have heard about the Panchadeva Upasana and why we should worship all these five forms in our daily lives.
Now, thank you.
My name is Anna and I'm 4 years old. Welcome to Mahakaya Suri Pati Samabhava. Me and Venu Kumi Deva Sarvataya Sushuda. Say the meaning of the Ganesh Mantra. O Bhagavan, with the curved trunk, large body, and the brilliance of 10 million suns, please remove all the obstacles and grant me success for all of my actions.
You close your eyes.
Papa is not allowed to see.
Samsara saram, puja kendra haram.
Namaste, Namami. Thank you.
Pranam Didi.
Pranam Didi Ji. Namaste, everyone.
My name is
I'm 6 years old, and I will say the meaning of Karpur Gola. I bow to that Kampadur White Complexion Lord Shiva, who is the incarnation of compassion, who is the essence of all lives, who wears and makes us garlands, who always resides in the heart of every eye. I bow to him, Lord Shiva, and his consort Parvati. Thank
you. First, Nitant, you are first.
Namaste, Didi Ji. Namaste, everyone. Namaste. My name is Nitant Utkarsh Parwar, and I'm going to say the mantra of Madhurka. Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvartha Sadike Sharanye Trayambake Gauri Narayani Namostute.
Very good.
Pranam Didi Ji. Namaste, everyone. My name is Vidar. I am 7 years old. Today I am going to say the meaning of Madhurka. Namaskar to Ma, the one with the fair complexion, who is the auspiciousness of all auspiciousness, the giver of good fortune and all kinds of accomplishments, the source of refuge and the mother of the three worlds, the supreme consciousness. Thank you.
Namaste, everyone. My name is Owen, and I'm 5 years old.
Hello. Sarvadam.
Yesham Adhisto Bhagavan.
Bye.